The people of Syria are really not being helped a whole lot. The government of Beirut does not allow UN refugee camps because the borders are porous and they're afraid of jihadists coming across. I went on contract with Catholic Near East Welfare to do stories on the Syrian refugees who were being helped by these wonderful humanitarian Good Shepherd nuns. And these nuns, in partnership with Pontifical Mission, provide them with shelter. They provide them with blankets, with mattresses, food, clothes for the children. The images that stand out in my mind when I first got there were these cinder block shelters that they're living in. And the first one had a purple couch and it had a huge hole behind it. And they were living next to these garbage dumps. One of them was two stories high. And one of the mothers was telling me that at night, big rats come in as a result of the garbage dump. The kids were playing with burnt rubber and with metal pieces. When I was there in the winter, the children were walking around with flip-flops on, and it was about to snow. Yes, they escaped the ravages of war, but they're living in total deprivation. The Good Shepherd Sisters are known for giving to women, children, families. They were just so generous, so giving, so loving, so caring, and the head Sister Micheline, she's everything, all rolled into one. Despite all the ravages of this war, she wants to see these kids get an education and get back on their feet. They haven't been in school in 3 years, most of them. It's a big drug country, and she was upset seeing these kids watering the cannabis. So she thought to herself, I've got to get these kids educated. So she went around to a number of NGOs, and she built this school. She's given these children some semblance of normalcy. They're helping them psychologically, they're helping them emotionally, they're helping to feed them. Once a week they get this hot meal, they don't get that otherwise. And the nuns even have Syrian teachers. One of the ways that the nuns are reaching them in school is they have them do drawings of their life in Syria. And it was all red, it was all bombs, guns, blood. Every single child in that second grade had almost the same drawing. You know, and the bad guys were over here, and the good guys were over here, and you know who was winning. It was a way for them, therapy-wise, to get out their past life and where they've been and what they've seen. I asked Sister Micheline, what was the most difficult thing for you about doing this? And she said to me, it's telling the families that I don't have the money to help you. And she said, that kills her. That really kills her. And so that got me. I felt this missionary zeal, which I have never felt before in my entire life, this pull to go back. I did not, because there were a series of bombings happening in Lebanon. So a friend of mine said to me, instead of you paying your fare to go back, why don't you do a fundraiser? I ended up having a party in my home and inviting friends and family, and we collected quite a bit of money for the nuns. And the nuns were so grateful because the program was almost canceled, and they were devastated at one point. The nuns are doing as much as they possibly can, and these kids would have nothing, you know. At least this is something for them to hold on to. But it's going to continue now, so that's good.